Hey guys, today is gonna be we're gonna do some weights as well, but it's gonna be focused on HIIT, so it's gonna be a lot of high energy work. So let's go ahead and get started. We're gonna get ourselves standing up in our power squat positions. Hands behind the head, pull the elbows back behind you, engage the shoulder blades, plant those feet down in front of you, and make sure your hips go back on these squats. Ready and begin. Dropping in each time. Breathing out, keep that chin tucked, your body follows. On the way up, you're following your breath out, on the way up. Keep going. All right, next thing we're gonna do, we're keeping the hands back here. We're gonna do a reverse lunge with some rotation. So check this out. I'm gonna lunge back and twist over my knee, stand up and switch sides. Exhale with that twist. Your knee can drop behind you each time. Three more. One more each side. Final one. Go to relax those arms. Being in that position, that position can really mess up, really not mess up, but fire up your upper back. So take those arms down for a second. We have jumping jacks and seal jacks next. Let's start in 3, 2, and 1. Keep going. And fling our seals. And relax. All right. Next thing we're gonna do is gonna be starting in a really wide stance. I'm gonna shift my weight over into that side squat position. All the way over, pick that toe up and hang out for a second. Feel a good groin stretch on the inside leg. And we're gonna come up and switch sides. ISO hang out right there. And up one more time each way. And over again. After doing those both sides, let's go ahead and take ourselves down to the ground. Starting out with alternating fire hydrants. Arms are strong. Swing that leg off to the side and begin. Big open up the hip. Slow and big, guys. After you guys do that one, we're gonna go onto our feet into shoulder taps. So get those feet back behind you, step out, lift yourself up, and now going back and forth with some shoulder taps, controlling the core, getting those shoulders in a good position, chest engaged. 3, 2, 1, and back down. Let's lay all the way down to our chest now. Hands can cross underneath the chin. Pick your feet up in the air, knees stay down. That windshield wiper, we're releasing our low back, crossing over, and picking up the other side. Two more. All right, lay your feet back down, hands on the shoulders, take a deep breath, bring your stomach up off the ground. Take a big breath, and now we're gonna look behind us to our feet, one direction, exhale, and switch sides. All right, bring yourself back up to tall. Last thing on warm up, we're going knee drive and butt kickers. Big arm action, and then make sure those knees come up with it. 2, 1, let's go, drive them up. We're gonna go butt kickers next in 2 and 1. Swing the feet back behind you. 3, 2, and done. Feel free to grab a quick drink of water. We're gonna get rolling in just a sec. Guys, have a mat, grab one. Today we're gonna be starting on the ground. It's gonna be kind of a gas out. We're gonna stick to the same exercise for 4 sets in a row. It's gonna be time based. So we're gonna go, think of it kind of a Tabata, but we are literally sticking to one exercise. We're gonna crush that muscle group, then move on to the next one. First round's gonna be relatively easier. Each set you do, that muscle gets more and more fatigued, and we're gonna try to keep that pace. So we're gonna do bicycle crunches to start. Laying on the ground, bicycle crunch. Work on not crunching up and down. You are rotating, but keeping the same ground contact in your low back. After the 20 seconds, we'll take a 15 second break. So it's 25 seconds on, 15 seconds off, and then we'll do that for four sets without anything else going on. So let me grab a mat, and we're gonna get rolling in just a second. Here we go, guys. Bicycle crunch in 3, 2, 1, clock starts now. Go ahead. Back and forth, exhale. Get your speed in play, or at least get a good pattern, rhythm down. Keep going. Keep going. Three, two, one. 15 seconds off again. This is where you do not want your core to start to leave, and use your upper back and lower back to keep that body in place. Push your core down, keep activating it. We got 7 more seconds off. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, third set. Keep going. Lock those legs out each time. Three, two, one. We got one more round to get through. Relax, let your stomach relax. Here we go, final round, Kate, let's do it. 3, 2, and 1. Flexors should be feeling it well as well. We're taking a mini break. We're going into the next exercise. This is going to be a push-up into a double shoulder tap. So don't rush your push-ups. One push-up on the way up, tap your shoulder, back down to the push-up, tap, tap. 25 seconds on. Feel free to do these on your knees, guys. This is a long time. I'm trying to get like 6 to 8 reps in 25 seconds, going slow and working on form. Time to do a shoulder tap. Five seconds. 2 and 1. 15 seconds off, we're doing it again. Don't rush these sets, guys. Every single one's gotta be consistent. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Keep going. Five seconds. Two and one, rest. 15 seconds again. I'm not getting up. Five seconds. Let's fight through this. Three, two, one. Left. Three, two, get that last one in there. One. All right. Okay, let's fight through. We got one more round here. Guys, slow it down and keep that form strong. Do not let your low back give. 5 seconds. All right, three, two, one. Keep it up. Five seconds. Two and one. Relax. All right, we're gonna be off of our arms. This is a stationary knee drive this time. A lot of arm action going here, and a lot of footwork. Catch your breath, 25 on, 15 off. Few more deep breaths, guys. Doing good.
We got 10 seconds. We're starting out that knee drive. Find your pace, drive the arms, and keep your face relaxed.
Here we go. Three, two, one. Let's go. Get in that rhythm. Stay upright and keep your arms going through your body, out in front of you. They cross the hip each time. Keep it up, keep it up. 5 seconds. Two and one, relax. 15 second break, we're going after it again.
Find a consistency in that pace. The first 10 seconds, work on form. The next 10 seconds, increase your pace. The last five, when I do that countdown, let's go all out.
5 seconds left. Okay, two, one, go. Get your form down. Focus on your arm action and your knee height. Chin tucked. All right, let's pick it up, let's pick it up. Okay, last 5 seconds, go, go, come on. Two, one, relax. Two sets down. All right, this one's coming up on us. Three, two, one, third set. All right, good work. Let's pick it up. Ten seconds. Ready. Five, four, three, two, time. One more round. Take a deep breath. 5 seconds left. Come on, Kate, let's dig in. Three, two, pick it up again. Arm action does not slow down. Keep the arms swinging big. Okay, that's our first 10 seconds. Let's pick it up.
And last five, coming up soon. Ready? Let's go. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. That was our fourth exercise. Our last one is these floor slams. Interlock the fingers, rotate the hip, and slam down. And we're going 4 sets with that as well. All right. Whew. Looking good, Kate. We're taking a big break after this set of four. We'll get our heart rate and everything after this. Here we go. Interlock those fingers, squat each time, rotate the hip, and slam. 5 seconds left. 2, 1, let's go. Seconds off. Five, four, three, two, go. Sets down, 2 to go. Inhale, exhale. Don't let that time on be any type of recovery. Push, push, push. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Squat, guys. Come on, get low. Five seconds. 2, 1. One more set. Five seconds. 3, 2, 1. Ready, set, go. Stop. All right, 15, 17 range is what we're looking for. Let's take a big break, get some water, guys. We're changing gears. Great first part of the workout. Next thing we're gonna need is a kettlebell. We're gonna go into more of a gear of a superset. We're gonna do a multiple names. It's a kettlebell swing to row. It's a kettlebell jackknife, something different you wanna call it. You wanna keep your feet planted. Remember, knees stay back, hips go back, upper back stays flat. You're gonna pull that bell between your legs, pop up with a hip extension. Make sure you're not leaning back, make sure you're just standing tall. So we're doing that kettlebell swing, but on that top of the swing, bring that bell towards your chest. There's a little bit of a row action on the way up. Timing of it. Forward, row, release, swing. That's our pace. As soon as we're done, very similar pattern, we're gonna go right into sprinter crunches on the ground. Laying down, drive one knee up, opposite hand comes with it, other hand goes behind your waist, then cross over the opposite way. Each one is timed. We're going 30 second swings, a 10 second break to get ready for the sprinter crunch, followed by 20 seconds of sprinter crunches. That means we're gonna be going on for a minute with that quick little transition phase. Here we go.
Grab that bell. 3, 2, 1. Row each time we come up. Breathe out, stand tall. When you're up there, it's not time to take a break. You are bracing your core and focusing on posture. Keep going. 3, 2, 1. Weight goes down. Set yourself up. We're going sprinter crunches pretty soon. All right. 3, 2, 1. Begin. Keep going. 3, 2, 1. All right, guys, that was our first set. We're gonna get right back in that pretty soon. So it was 30 seconds of swings, quick transition, 20 seconds of sprinter crunches. We got 3 more rounds. Keep going. 10 seconds. 5, 3, 2, 1. All right. 7 seconds. Let's get down and get ready. 3, 2, 1. Yourselves ready again. We are halfway through. High knees, hips fold back. Keep it up. Strong core, keep your chest strong on the way up, and keep your shoulder blades back. You're not reaching down for that bell. It stays close to your body. 10 seconds. Power up, let's go. Squeeze your feet. 3, 2, 1. Sprinter crunch is coming up. Let's find that pace. Dig in to get up. Use your muscles fast, fast twitch muscles to get up quickly. 2, 1.
Go. Come on. Three, two, one. Three down. All right. Hey guys, as we're getting tired and thinking, oh, I'm almost done, let's go over from the ground up our cues to the swing. Squeeze your feet. Make sure they're facing forward and not too far away. This happens when people get tired from bending over. Feet, neutral, grip of the ground, squeeze them, right? Hips are the ones that move. The knees stay vertical, the hips go back. Chest stays big, your shoulders don't want to come in front of your body when you're doing this really long swing like this. You never even come up all the way. Keep the arms pulled back slightly, and stand up tall each time. When you're tall, glutes are firing and core is firing to get up. And by the way, the kettlebell swing is not this slow movement. It's a pop, it's powerful. You have to use your hips, smack them up fast. It's not this pace. This is not what we're looking for. You're going down and popping on the way up. Let's get a little more aggressive. This is your last set. Do your best one. That's what it is for a reason. Get the most out of this one. Here we go. Three, two, one. Fold, pop. Ten seconds. Five. Two, one, bell goes down. Let's get the spinal crunches in. Three, two, one. Breathe out every time. All right, guys, while we take a little mini break, let's talk about breathing. Why are we supposed to breathe every rep? So our abdomen, our core, it has a lot of functions to it. One is to relax, to let us take that deep breath in. When our stomach relaxes, it can expand. Vice versa, when it contracts, it pushes air out. It also creates a really strong brace in our body. If you guys flex your core, it pulls a big bridge right in our core, right here between our ribs and our hips, and it creates that bridge feeling, that like sense of security, that sense of bracing something. Instead of using all those muscles in your spine and your back, like back muscles, those QLs, those guys do not want to recruit what their core is supposed to do. So if you're not breathing properly or holding your breath and you're holding in, you're not creating that tension. What happens there, you start getting that low back pain. Or even worse, you start relying on your spine, the skeletal structure, to hold loads in. And that's what you guys want to stay away from. If you keep loading in your lower back, you're gonna feel that disc slip, or even something worse, like a muscle spasm that really locks up and you're stuck for a while. So think about when you guys are breathing out, one, you're breathing, getting oxygen back to your body, and two, you are bracing every movement you do. When it comes to resistance training and core work, everything's about exhaling through and keeping your body strong there. So think about the tempo. It helps in a lot of different ways too. For me, I count throughout my breath. One, it keeps you at a pattern. It keeps you consistent. So keep that in mind. We're gonna do our last little bit here and then we're gonna be done for the day. Let's, first of all, I need to get some water. I've been talking this whole time. Give me 2 seconds. So this is gonna be a lot different with your kettlebell. We're doing it at a pinch grip. We haven't done this on Zoom in a very long time. You are not holding on to that bell. Your fingers never come underneath.
your thumbs on one side and your fingers on the opposite side, and that tension you create holds the bell up.
If 30 is too heavy, go back to your dumbbells and pinch grip even better. But if you can, try to grip that bell. We're gonna do single arm kettlebell, right arm first. Make sure you don't lean, stay tall. While we're doing a pinch grip, we're gonna go into a calf raise. After doing that calf raise pinch grip, we're gonna switch sides and then continue it up. The calf raise is about balance and not rocking. You're not gonna go like this. You're not going heels to toes and just doing this back and forth movement. Stay tall, strike with a pause, control. Strike with a pause, control. We're doing both sides back to back. As soon as we're done, we're gonna go kettlebell pulse squat. So we're gonna grab the weight with both arms and we're gonna be in that middle doing that pulse pace, all right? Get this heavy 44 out of here. Let's grab those bells. Pinch grip on one side and calf raise at the same time. Stay balanced. Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Find your pinch grip, raise up to your toes each time. Staying balanced. Remember, your fingers are not touching each other. Keep going. We're gonna switch sides in 8 seconds. 3, 2, 1. Switch arms, keep going. 3, 2, 1, to one side. Keep your shoulder blades down, guys. Posture, posture, posture. Keep yourself upright. These calves can do a lot of reps. They're built and designed for walking far distances and running for a long time. So think about these rep counts should be very high. 2, 1. All right, grab that weight. We're going right to pull squats. 3, 2, 1. Find that middle ground and own it. You don't have to pulse fast. You gotta stay in that tension range. Track the knees out of the feet. Squeeze the ground. Next set, starting upstroke. Here we go. 5 seconds. Pinch grip. 2, 1. Begin. Balance. Pull squat. 3, 2, and 1. Ready? Begin. Up. 5 seconds. 2 and 1. You got one more set. All right. guys, take a little bit more time off. Things to think about when we're doing that pinch grip is what your shoulder's doing. Don't let it get super stiff and close to your body. You gotta keep it natural where it's supposed to be. Shoulder blade stays down. If you have a mirror or you're looking at yourself on the camera, make sure your chest and your shoulders are neutral. Don't let this happen. Keep them flat.
All right. Here we go. 3 seconds. Grab that weight. 2, 1. Two and switch. Keep going. Those calves and those feet are getting tired. Keep fighting. Let's go. 5 seconds. Pulse squat in 3, 2, 1, grab that weight and let's get rolling. Brace your core, keep that back strong. Our finisher is gonna be a one set core. We're going 40 seconds straight, knee grabs, traditional knee grabs. Find your rhythm, find your pace. And let's take a seat when you're ready. I feel like I'm an old man getting down on that one. All right, hands under the chin. Drive your heels towards your butt and literally grab your knees on the way up. Things to avoid is that forward head position here. Be upright, even lean back. This is fine for the knee grab. Don't have to come through it like this, all right? Here we go. 40 seconds straight. 3, 2, 1. Halfway. Five, four, three, two, time. All right. Okay, nice work. We're gonna go right into a butterfly stretch. Plant those feet down, cross into here. After a few seconds, we're gonna go straight leg with one leg and cross over the opposite leg. 3, 2, and straighten out, cross over. Take that elbow and pull it across even more. After this stretch, let's go ahead and roll over to our side. Grab your ankle, pull all the way back to the quad. And
Switch. And then we're gonna go into a calf stretch to finish up. A lot of calf raises today. So roll on your chest, press, cross over one leg, and press your heel down. Switch one, ready? All right, guys, good work today.
Catch y'all soon.